Want Midjourney to replicate a style that you love? No problem. Let's explore Midjourney's newest tool, the Style Reference Parameter, --SREF. After you watch this video, you're going to be a pro at being able to define what Midjourney's Style Reference Parameter is, how to use the Style Reference Parameter in Midjourney, bonus tip at the end, how you can make that process very efficient. So buckle in till the very end and let's roll. So what exactly is the style reference feature? Well, imagine your favorite image and being able to replicate that to ensure a consistent style in your images. Very cool, very useful. Here's how you do it. After you type out your main prompt, just add a --SREF space, and then paste the URL of your style reference image. Now, you can grab links to an image in three different ways. Perhaps you want to use an image that you already see on Midjourney's Explore page, or you want to use an image that you've created before within Midjourney, or you have an image whose style you want to replicate within Midjourney. If you want to use an image from the Explore page, you just head on over, right click, and copy the URL. You can then use it in your prompt as a style reference. If there's an image that you've created, you can just drag the image over so that Midjourney grabs the URL of it. Or you can use any image that you have. I have this one image whose style I absolutely love, and it's exactly perfect for what I need. So let me show you using that image. Isn't the style on this one magnificent? I want to create images with the same style. So the first thing I'll do is drag the image into Midjourney. And the one thing you don't want to forget to do is press enter. All right, now that we have the image uploaded onto Midjourney, we can enter our prompt. I want to create a landscape of Toronto. So let me type that out. And I'll add my image as a style reference by adding --SREF space and then the URL of the image. I can just drag over the image and Midjourney will copy the URL. Let's give it a go. Don't forget to make sure that there is a space between SREF and the URL. Okay, I am so excited to see the result of this prompt. All right, abracadabra. Look at that. How stunning. I think this one is my favorite. Let's enlarge that one. Look at that. Perfection. Midjourney did a great job at capturing the style and implementing it within this landscape image. By using the style reference code within Midjourney, you can create images with the same style without you having to specify it and type out long descriptions. Previously, you could get the same results by using the remix or style tuning feature, but this makes it a lot easier and simpler to accomplish. With version 6, you just provide the style reference and Midjourney will create an image with the same style. If you found this video helpful so far, don't forget to hit that like button and smash subscribe. Okay, let's get back to the party. Now, you're already feeling like a pro, but wait, there is more. You can also play with the weight parameter called the style weight, --SW. When you add it after the style reference code, it defines how much the style will impact the output. Higher weight, up to 1000, will mean more of an influence of the style reference image. A lower value will give you a result with less of an impact of the style reference image. You can play around with the style weight to get the perfect image that you're looking for. The default is 100, but you can go anywhere from 0 to 1000. I'll show you the same image with different style weights, so you can really see the difference that the style weight makes to the image and the impact it has on the final output. I prefer the style weight of 100 because I find that it gives me the best results, but you go ahead and experiment and see what works for you. Remember, style weight of 0 means that there will be no impact of the style on your final output. Style weight of 100 is the default, and style weight of 1000 is the highest you can go. At such a high level, you'll even begin to see elements from the reference image in your final output, so tread carefully. Now, here's where it gets interesting. You might be wondering, well, what's the difference between using a style reference versus just adding the image URL into the prompt? When you add the image URL, you add it at the beginning of the prompt, and that brings in the actual content from the image into your prompt. But with the style reference, it's all about the colors, the aesthetics, the vibe. Let me show you an example. In this prompt, we're using the image URL within the prompt. Here are the results. Now we'll try the same prompt, but in this version, we'll use --SREF. the style reference parameter. See the difference? In the version with the URL prompt, you can see that the landscape and the girl's face is also reflected in the final output. The image's semantic content heavily influences the output, so any objects, the subject, are actually appearing in the final output. Whereas the prompt that uses the same image as a style of reference, you see that the style, the color, the vibe, the aesthetics are represented, but the actual content from the image is not reflected in the final output. And what's even cooler is that you can add multiple style references to blend different styles together. Just separate each URL with a space, you are going to get some amazing results. Now, here's another trick. If you're using the same style reference frequently, putting in the URL is going to get old real quick. Now, here's a nifty trick. You can actually save that style reference as a custom option. You can do this simply by using the prefer set option command within Midjourney. Just give it a name and you're all set. Now, every time you add in that custom name, Midjourney knows what you're talking about and it'll add that style reference to your image without you having to grab the URL every time. Now, you might be seeing people share style reference codes and you might be wondering, hey, where do I get this code for my image? Unfortunately, you can't. The only way to get a style reference code is to try the --SREF random feature. If you want to experiment and give Midjourney the reins and see what it comes up with, you can use a random style by adding --SREF random at the end of your prompt. Midjourney will then assign it a random style and you'll see the code for that style appear in your prompt. You can share these style reference codes with other users so that they can try out the same style, or you can use that code yourself to create images with the same style. Again, all you gotta do is add --SREF and the code at the end of your prompt, and you'll get an image with the same style. So there you have it, style references within Midjourney, an amazing way to add consistent style within your images. All right, now go out there and create some stunning visuals and let me know how it goes in the comments below. I'll see you in the next video.